Thank you. We want to be sure that we have quite a few more people on the list, so if we'd really stick to our time frames. Next up, Mr. Gary Gill, please.
Hello, everybody. I'm Gary Gill. I formerly was the environmental director for the state of Hawaii, so I have some background in this. I want to keep it really simple. Three things: risk, timing, and trust. I think people are here concerned about the risk. Even if we hear that the water is safe today, what about tomorrow? What about it catastrophically? The only way to reduce that risk to zero is to do away with red tape.
Yes.
Well, so if you have questions, ask a question.
Let him talk. Let him talk.
There are questions here. Okay. Short of reducing that risk to zero, the game here really is how do you reduce it to as much as is feasible or practical. We could cut the risk in half if we were to reduce the number of tanks currently holding fuel in half.
Yeah.
Currently, there are 20 tanks. Correct me if I'm wrong. I believe there are 15 that are filled. Going by your own analysis, what I heard that 5 of those 15 have actually been upgraded. That means 10 tanks are filled now but have not been upgraded. So that's a big risk. Question: to reduce the risk, can the Navy reduce the number of tanks that are currently filled with gas? Second point, tied into that, timing, risk timing. One thing people are concerned about is it takes 20 years to get to this end of the AOC
system. So.
What about 10 years? If we reduce the number of tanks in service by half, we can cut 20 years to 10. That is a suggestion I'd like you to consider. And as to trust, can we trust the results of all the contractors and everybody? Oversight, transparency is important. Can we, as we take these samples from the monitoring wells, take a split sample, have the Navy test it, have the EPA and the DOH test it, and let the Board of Water Supply
But the question is, but the concern is, we have to determine from a bigger perspective what we need to have here for Red Hill to exist. Because at some point, the reason for existing and the risk mitigation will counteract each other. So that's why I talked about this earlier. Part of the process here, and this is above, I mean, this is above us here from the Navy perspective, is the why Red Hill and how much it takes to do that. Okay, so I don't want to confuse anyone here on this. So that there is a reason for it, and we have the amount of fuel in the mountain based on the reasons that I laid out. So if we were just to arbitrarily cut that in half, the question would be, would Red Hill still serve the purpose that it's intended to do because it's here?
So I wanted to add a little bit to that and give a little wider perspective. We're studying the risk posed by Red Hill. I'm not sure if reducing the number of tanks in half would reduce risk in half. I think the answer is probably not. We, working with the Navy, have essentially encouraged them through the AOC process to hire a very expert-level contractor that typically does risk assessments for the nuclear power industry to look at nuclear power plants to make sure they don't pose a threat. That's the level of risk assessment we're doing here at Red Hill. The tanks are part of the risk equation, but there's other parts of the facility, like the piping. And that may actually be a greater risk than the tanks. We don't know that yet. We're studying it. But reducing the piping is the same no matter how many tanks you have. So this is an important aspect of the work we're doing. So we're really trying to find the vulnerabilities of the facility and make sure the resources are invested to correct those vulnerabilities. And as for the suggestion about split sampling, we are already in the process of working on a contract to start doing split sampling for some of the groundwater work at Red Hill to verify the Navy's results.
Okay, risk, trust, and speed.
Timing.
Okay, I want to make sure. So we've had 5 tanks already gone through the modified API inspections and are back in service. The 6th tank, tank 5, is currently midway through, or we're doing that one right now. And just at the end of August, we awarded 2 task orders. valued at about $35 million to do the next five tanks. So we are accelerating that. We did take lean forward with tank five still being out of service to go ahead and do the next five, targeting the ones that have, you know, been the longest period of time that since they have had an inspection. So we are committed to speeding that process up to at least go in and maintain, scan, assess the condition of the tanks that haven't been opened. Risk and trust.
I want to address the trust issue as well, because that's the, you know, that's our role, EPA, DOH, we're regulatory agencies. We're overseeing the work that Andy's doing. We are working hard to make sure there's adequate transparency. If you look at our website, DOH's website, there's a huge amount of information on there related to red LED we put up there. We're reviewing the work the Navy's doing. If we see something wrong, we don't like it, we reject it. There's been some press about that recently, about a plan for doing an investigation that we didn't like. We think it needs to be changed, be improved. And that's part of the process. We're overseeing them, and we welcome your comments all the time. We're open for comments 24/7.
Okay, so we did validate. We did talk about that this week. We met with DOH, EPA, Board of Water Supply, and they did bring up the split sample. So that'll be something we'll look at. And we want to make sure that test is done, that there's a good analytical process so that they're done at the same time, using the same method, so that we can have trust in the results that we get, that they're
put up there. We're reviewing the work the Navy's doing. If we see something wrong, we don't like it, we reject it. There's been some press about that recently, about a plan for doing an investigation that we didn't like. We think it needs to be changed, be improved. And that's part of the process. We're overseeing them, and we welcome your comments all the time. We're open for comments 24/7.
Okay, so we did validate. We did talk about that this week. We met with DOH, EPA, Board of Water Supply, and they did bring up the split sample. So that'll be something we'll look at. And we want to make sure that test is done, that there's a good analytical process so that they're done at the same time, using the same method, so that we can have trust in the results that we get, that they're...
Okay, next up